Very good morning to all of you. Today the class is on chemistry of lipids. So what is this title slide shows you? So you can see some chips, nuts, and here you can see some oils, okay, and all this, and here also. So this will help you to know more, more to know about the lipids. Okay. Next is this. What is the definition for lipids? And next one, you have to learn about the classification. And after that, the importance. Okay, so first one is definition. So definition for lipids. Lipids are nothing but they are the organic substances relatively insoluble in water, but soluble in organic solvents like chloroform, ether, and benzene. So chloroform, ether, and benzene. These are the examples for organic solvents in which the lipids would be soluble. So the organic substances relatively insoluble in water but soluble in organic solvents like chloroform, ether, and benzene. Lipids are organic compounds formed mainly from alcohol and fatty acids, which are combined together or linked by the ester. So it is by the ester link. So you can have a look at this picture. So it is a fatty alcohol and this is a fatty acid which is acted upon by esterase, gives you an ester. That is the lipid. Okay. So that's why we say it is, here you can see, it is mainly from alcohol and fatty acids combined together by the ester linkage. Okay. What are the various functions of lipids? So number one, it stores the energy. So it is a storage form of energy. Then it gives structure. So structural component for the cell membrane. And precursors of many steroid hormones like vitamin B. It gives protection to the internal. The compounds which they include, lipid compounds, they are fats and oils. We say it as triglycerides, waxes, steroids, fat-soluble vitamins, phospholipids, mono and diglycerides. These are the few examples which has lipids. How do you classify? Coming on to classification of lipids. So lipids are classified into simple lipids, complex lipids, and third one is derived lipids. So simple, what are simple lipids? Under simple lipids, they are the esters of fatty acids with various alcohols. The type of alcohols, based on that, it is classified as, here the alcohol is glycerol and it is a, we say it as neutral fats or oils. Next one is waxes. Here the alcohol is other than glycerol. So see the difference between these two. alcohol. Here in neutral fats, it is the alcohol is glycerol. In waxes, the alcohol is other than glycerol. So this difference you have to note it. So these are examples. Okay, so when you go to market, you see so many lipid containing or fats containing fats containing food items, okay, and oils. What are neutral fats or oils? So the neutral fats and oils are also called as the triglycerides. They are the esters of glycerol with three molecules of fatty acid. So let's have a look at this picture. So here it is. This is a glycerol molecule. Combines with three molecules of fatty acids, you get a compound called as the triglycerol. Understood? Okay. So glycerol plus fatty acids, they give rise to TAG or triglyceride or triacylglycerol. So next is waxes. So under wax, when hydrolysis of wax, it gives one fatty acid molecule and alcohol. So these are the few examples. So you can appreciate this picture. So it is beeswax and complex lipids. Second is complex lipids. Complex lipids, they are the esters of fatty acids with various alcohols, and in addition, it contains other than the other group also. It is subclassified according to the type of presence of prosthetic group. So, phospholipids. So, as the name suggests, phospholipids is something to do with the phosphate group. Next one is glycolipids. So, glycolipid is nothing but it is the something to do with the carbohydrate. Then lipoproteins. So, lipid and so phospholipids. So, under phospholipids, it contains lipid, alcohol, fatty acid, phosphoric acid, nitrogenous base and other alcohol group. So here you can see glycerol molecule attached to phosphate. Okay. So that way it is phospholipid. Okay. And here also you see phosphatidic acid, you have phosphoric acid here. And here lecithin, that is phosphatidylcholine, you see the phosphoric acid. So these are few examples. That's why it is defined as it is the combination of lipid, alcohol, fatty acid, phosphoric acid, nitrogenous base and other alcohol. Phospholipids, again, it is divided into two groups, that is glycerophospholipids and sphingolipids. So glycerophospholipids, here glycerol, phosphate and alcohol. Okay. And here in sphingolipids, the alcohol is sphingosin. So to the sphingosin, fatty acid, phosphate and choline. Okay, so phospholipids are divided into two groups based on the presence of alcohol. So one is glycerophospholipid is nothing but the alcohol group is glycerol, and in sphingolipids, the alcohol is sphingosin. So that it is divided according to the presence of the type of alcohol which is present in it. Next is glycerophospholipids. Here the alcohol is glycerol. Examples, plasma halogens and cardiolipins. Sphingophospholipids, alcohol is sphingosine. Examples, sphingomyelins. Glycolipids, they do not contain phosphate group. Instead, so it is fatty acid, alcohol. Alcohol may be sphingosine, carbohydrate, and it is with a nitrogenous base. Okay, here you have to know or remember that they do not contain phosphate group. Examples, cerebrosides and gangliosides. Third example is lipoproteins. So what are lipoproteins? Lipoproteins are nothing but lipids with prosthetic group, the protein. And the chylomicrons, examples, chylomicrons, what are the lipoprotein examples? Chylomicrons, very low density lipoprotein, VLDL, low density lipoproteins, LDL, high density lipoproteins, HDL. This is a tabulation with examples, the whole classification of lipids. So simple lipids, triacylglycerol or triglycerides or neutral fat. And next one is waxes. So they come under simple lipids. Second one is the compound lipids. Under compound lipids, it is phospholipids containing phosphoric acid. Under that, you have one more classification, that is nitrogen containing glycerophosphatidates. They are lecithin. Lecithin is nothing but phosphatidyl choline. Cephalin, it is phosphatidyl ethanol amine. Phosphatidyl serine. Non nitrogen glycerophosphatidates, it is phosphatidyl inositol, phosphatidyl glycerol, diphosphatidyl glycerol, that is cardiolipin. So these are under non-nitrogen glycerophosphatidates. Third one is plasmalogens, having long chain alcohol. It is choline plasmalogen and ethanolamide plasmalogen. Fourth subgroup is phosphosphingosides with sphingosine. Example is sphingomyelin. So these are all under compound lipids, under phospholipids containing phosphoric acid. Okay. So next one is like non-phosphorylated lipids. So in non-phosphorylated lipids, it is glycosphingolipids, which has carbohydrate as the moiety. Then cerebrosides, the ceramide monoxides, then globocytes, ceramide oligosaccharides, gangliosides, ceramide oligosaccharides with neuraminic acid. Next is sulfolipids or sulfatides. They are sulfated cerebrosides, sulfated globocytes, sulfated gangliosides. Third one is derived lipids. They are the fatty acids, steroids, prostaglandins, leukotrienes, terpenes, and oligos. These are examples for derived lipids. Then fourth one is lipids complex to other compounds. They are proteolipids and lipoproteins. Derived lipids. What are derived lipids? Derived lipids, they are derived from lipids, maybe from simple or complex. They are the precursors of lipid synthesis. Example, fatty acids, steroids, cholesterol, and vitamin A and D. So under cholesterol, this is with the help of the enzyme desmolase, you get pregnenolone. Pregnenolone is further broken down or acted upon by this enzyme, 3-beta-hydroxysteroid dehydrogenase, progesterone to progesterone. With the help of the enzyme 17-alpha-hydroxylase, you get a compound from progesterone to 17-alpha-hydroxyprogesterone. From here, from 17-alpha-hydroxyprogesterone, with the help of the enzyme 21-alpha-hydroxylase, you get 11-deoxycortisol or 11-deoxycortisol is formed. And from the same 17-alpha-hydroxyprogesterone, you also get a compound called as the androstenedione. Okay. So this is an example for androgens. And this gives rise to testosterone, and further it is broken down finally to estradiol. Okay. And with the help of the enzymes 21-alpha-hydroxylase, progesterone is acted by this 21-alpha-hydroxylase, and it gives rise to 11-deoxycorticosterone to corticosterone by the enzyme 11-beta-hydroxylase. Then finally, it gives a compound aldosterone, which is final product, okay, from cholesterol. And from here, 11-deoxycortisol, it is finally giving a rise to cortisol. And here, the peripheral tissues, okay, from androstenedione to testosterone, further it is converted to estradiol. All this happens where this is synthesized steroid hormone is synthesized in which part of the kidney? It is in the adrenal cortex. Okay, adrenal glands. And whereas this alone is not in adrenal cortex. So mind it, it is different. Okay, so it is an androgen, androstenedione to testosterone, then finally to estradiol. Fatty acids, they are simplest form of lipids, aliphatic monocarboxylic organic acids with hydrocarbon side chains. Fatty acids are included in the group of derived lipids. It's the most common component of lipids in the body. Free fatty acids are formed only during metabolism. The general formula is RCOOH. So this is for fatty acid. Okay. Next one is R stands for alkyl, or it is a hydrocarbon chain. COOH is the carboxyl end. And this occurs mainly in esters in the natural fats and oils. Even an orange-carbon fatty acids. Fatty acids which occurs in natural lipids are of always even carbons. So they are about 14 to 20 carbon atoms. This is due to the biosynthesis of fatty acids, mainly which occurs in sequential addition of two carbon units. Palmitic acid has 16 carbon atoms, and stearic acid as 18 carbon atom, which are most common. Okay. Propionic acid is with 3 carbon atom, and valeric acid 5 carbon atom. They are common odd-shaped fatty acids. Examples. Numbering. How it is numbered? So the carbon atoms are numbered from COH group as number 1. The carbons adjacent to this are named as like this 2, 3, 4, etc. Or it can be said as the alpha, beta, gamma, etc. So carboxyl group of carbon is considered as the termed as the C1. Next carbon will be the C2, like that and so on. And alpha carbon, next is beta and so on. Last carbon atom from methyl group, H3, that is said as the omega carbon atom. General structure of fatty acid. Fatty acids are amphipathic molecules composed of an hydrophilic or polar ionized head are formed by the carboxyl group, and a hydrophobic or non-polar or non-ionized is a tail that is formed by the hydrocarbon chain. The degree of solubility of fatty acid depends on the presence of length of the hydrocarbon chain. So that's very important. So now you see CH3, CH2N. This is a hydrophobic hydrocarbon chain. COO minus. This is hydrophilic carboxyl group. Okay. So this is polar water soluble, whereas this is non-polar water insoluble. Numbering of the carbon atoms in fatty acid. So how are you going to number it? So this is CH3, CH2, CH2, COH. This is a butyric acid, which has 4 carbon atoms. Okay. So this COH, from here it will be named number 1, number 2, number 3, and number 4. And we say this alpha, beta, gamma, delta, like that. Okay. So here it will be, this is an omega end. Okay, methyl end is said as the omega end. And this alpha will be 1, beta and 1, 2, 3 and 4. So this is for omega numbers. And this is in Arabic, that is normally 1. So methyl end is nothing but the omega numbers. Okay. Classification of fatty acids. So according to the chain length, it is classified as short, medium and long. According to the degree of saturation, it is said as the saturated and unsaturated. According to the biological value, it is said as the essential and non-essential, aliphatic, branched and cyclic. So these are the phase. Classification of fatty acids, we can just go through this. Depending on the total number of carbon atoms, even chain, they have carbon atoms, that is 2, 4, 6 and similar series. And these are occurring naturally, which is said to be as even chain fatty acids. Odd chain fatty acids, this is the odd chain fatty acids, they have in odd numbers 3, 5 and 7. Odd number fatty acids are seen in microbial cell walls. They are also present in the milk. Depending on the length of the hydrocarbon chain, second classification, short chain with 2 to 6 carbon atoms, then medium chain with 8 to 14 carbon atoms, long chain with 16 and above, usually up to 24 carbon atoms. Very long chain fatty acids, more than 24 carbon atoms. Next classification is depending on nature of hydrocarbon chain. Saturated fatty acids, unsaturated fatty acids, classified as monounsaturated, having single double bond, or polyunsaturated with two or more double bonds. Then branch chain amino acids and hydroxy fatty amino acids. So just have a look at this. What is it actually? It is antioxidant. All these components, rich in antioxidant. The importance of this, we'll discuss it. Okay. According to the chain length, the fatty acids are classified into short chain fatty acids, that is from 2 to 6 carbon atom, medium chain 8 to 14 C, and long chain more than 24 carbon atoms. Classification of fatty acids. So already we have seen a complete description in our tabulation few minutes ago. According to the chain length, low or short chain fatty acids, it contains 8 carbon atoms or less from 2 to 6. Acetic acid, then butyric acid. Okay, these are few examples for short chain fatty. Short chain fatty acids. Second one is medium chain fatty acids. So it contains 8 to 14 carbon atoms. High or long chain fatty acids, the palmitic acid with 16C, then stearic C with 18C, and lignocerin with 24C. So the formula, chemical formula is here. You can just go. Classification of fatty acids according to the degree of saturation. So that was one for the number of carbon atoms. Okay. It is divided into short chain, then medium chain, and the long chain fatty acid. So this is under this categorization or classification is according to degree of saturation. Saturated fatty acids, they do not contain double bonds. Example, palmitic acid, stearic acid. Okay. Unsaturated fatty acids, they contain one or more double bonds. They are named by adding suffix enoic. Unsaturated fatty acids exhibit the geometrical isomerism at the double bonds. They also occur naturally. So all are naturally occurring fatty acids. They have cis configuration. Example, uric acid is an omega 9. So you have a double bond. Here. So it is said as the omega 9. So what is what for this case? So this is with 18 carbon atom, folic acid has 18 carbon atom, and this one is a number of double bond. You have one double bond, and this is at the ninth place. Okay, here. So you have a double bond here. So we say it from the methyl end. So it is said to be as the omega 9. Classification of unsaturated fatty acids is again divided into monounsaturated fatty acids. They contain only one double bond. So already I explained to you, it is 18, which has 18 carbon atom, one double bond, and at the ninth omega from that's why it's called as omega 9. Polyunsaturated fatty acids, they are polyenoic. They contain more than one double bond. It's called as the POFA or polyunsaturated fatty acid. polyunsaturated fatty acid. Examples: linoleic acid, which has 18 carbon atoms, and delta 9. So you have a double bond there. So two double bonds in the place 9 and 12. So it is an omega 6 family. So when you have it 6, that is from the methyl end, we say it as the omega. Okay, so omega 6 and omega 9. Okay, so you have two double bonds here. So one I'll explain so that you will understand. So it is linoleic acid. Then linolenic, it is C18. You have three double bonds in the place 9, 12, and 15. So you can have a look at this 15, 12, and 9. Number one, this is the, that is one, the carboxyl end, and here it is 9, 1, okay, 12, and 15. Then arachidonic acid, it is with a 20 carbon atom. So you have four double bonds in what are the places? In fifth carbon atom, then 8th, 11th, and 4th. Okay, so it is omega 6 family from here. So this is for academic interest. You can just see coconut oil, how much percentage you have saturated fatty acids. It is 86. Monounsaturated fatty acid, it is 12. Then PUFA, it is 2%. Groundnut oil, 18. Then here it is 46. And here it is 36. Sunflower oil, saturated 12. Then 24. Then 64. Butter 75, 20, and 5. 5% of polyunsaturated fatty acids. Fish oil, it is 30, 13, and 57. So it's with this star denotes saturated fats with medium chain fatty acids, and double stars, it would be erucic acid, okay, 22C and 1W. So we only concentrate on the. Clinical significance of polyunsaturated fatty acids. Linoleic and linolenic acids, they are polyunsaturated fatty acids. They are called essential fatty acids because they cannot be synthesized by the body, and they have to be supplied in the diet. Unsaturated fatty acids are also designated as omega 3 family, that is linolenic, and omega 6 linoleic and arachidonic, and omega 9 family oleic acid. So arachidonic acid is the precursor of prostaglandins. Arachidonic acid can be synthesized in the body if the essential fatty acids are supplied in the diet. The pentaenoic acid present in fish oil is of great nutritional importance. Eicosanoids are derived from 20C arachidonic acid. They are polyenoic fatty acids. They are prostanoids, that is prostaglandins, prostacyclins, and thromboxanes and leukotrienes. That ends with classification of the fatty acids. Next, we'll move on to properties of fatty acids. First one is hydrogenation. So unsaturated fatty acids, they may be converted to corresponding saturated fatty acids by hydrogenation of the double bond. So you have linoleic acid, is converted into hydrogenation. What happens here is the addition of two molecules of hydrogen, linoleic, then oleic, then hydrogenation of oils can lead to solidification and saturation. Example, vanaspati. melting point. The short and medium chain fatty acids are liquids, whereas long chain fatty acids are solids at 250 degrees centigrade. Unsaturated fatty acids, they have lower melting point compared to saturated fatty acids with same chain length. Next one is stearic acid, CAD acid, which has no double bond, has the melting point of 90 degrees. Oleic acid has 130 degrees centigrade. Sorry.